Welcome back. This is the last but one, module 5, water transportation. Now what the contents we are going to look at? Very first one is the types of water transportation. Then we will go with what is the harbor. We also want to know what is the difference between the harbor and the port. After that we are going to see what are different types of the harbor. And the last one, and which is the major portion of this, is the components of harbor. Now what is water transportation? Basically, amongst all the three modes, transportation mode, we have already learned with the previous two. This is the last one, water transportation, where it is divided into two types. One is the inland transportation and the second one is the ocean transportation. So in inland transportation, it involves river transportation and the canal transportation, whereas in ocean, which is the wide one, and most of the trading will be based on the ocean transportation. About 75% of the international trading, which is done with the shipping. And the second characteristic of this ocean transportation is there is no limitation for carrying the load capacity, and it is highly flexible as far as the time concern. Now what are the different advantages for this water transportation? The first one is it provides means of defense. Second one is the cheapest mode. You can very much compare with the other modes of transportation for the longer distance. So this will be a cheaper one. Then it leads to overall development of the commerce, industry and international trade. This will also get affected where the harbor and the ports they are situated. Then next one, high load carrying capacity, where the load limitations are there with the cargo aircrafts. So this will for a very large extent can carry the load. Then it encourages the consumption of foreign goods. And the last one, requires cheap motive power for its working. Now what are the disadvantages? As you can see, it is very slow in operation as compared to the rest. So this is a comparison with the other modes of operation. So therefore it consumes more time. It is useful only when water is available. So definitely in the, you can say, we are, when we're talking about the water transportation, doesn't only relate to the ocean, it may be a canal or river also. So in case of when there is no water or less amount of the water, shallow water, in that case this will not be effective. Then it may lead to accidents due to frequent ocean storms. This is mostly when the shipping is done. Then it has more chances of attack by the other countries. So international conflicts could also be there. Then it encourages consumption of foreign goods. And last one, requires cheap motive power for its working. Now you can see here, the major ports of the world, whereas in India, as far as India concerned, in Mumbai, Nhava Sheva is the port. Nowadays, even though harbor, we say that it is mostly known as the Nhava Sheva port. We are going to look at in further slides what is the difference between the harbor and the port. So this is the most of the busiest the harbors around the world. Now look at what is the harbor. So what is the harbor? Harbor is a place that is situated on the coast where different ships, boats, barge can be moved safely. So in very simple terms, if you want to define, just like the different the vehicles, let it be on running on the roads, or let it be trains running on the tracks, railway trains, you can say. So that for a time being requires some haltage. So where the harbor is a place which requires the halting of this stationing of these ships, boats and barge. So there will be different activities which will be going on this harbor. So functions of harbors, we will see. It is a sheltered area of a sea in which the vessels could be built or repaired or launched. So what is a vessels? Vessels are nothing but any, we can say just like any vehicle running on the road. So it will start from the very two wheeler to very four wheeler car. So which encompasses all the, let it be a two wheeler bike, let it be a rickshaw, let it be a car. So just like a vessel which is starting from very small boat to a very large ship. Similarly, it could seek refuge in time of storm. So what it means, just like emergency, in case of emergency the airplane has to land somewhere, so in that case we call it as a, for the oceanic storm, so where the large ship they have to be stationed or need some halt, so in that case it will also provide a shelter. So third one, it provides loading and unloading of cargo and passengers. So this is the third function, just like in the trains which are carrying the passengers as well as the commodities. So here you can see the layout of the harbor. So these are the port or harbor, these are synonymous words, but it has both has the some specific meaning. So you can see there is a, you can say, a naval port which is said. This is one of the space which is reserved for the naval bases. Then this one is the quay or wharf. We are going to look at these terms one by one. Now here is called the pier B, here is the pier 4. So one word we must have seen here is called the pier. Then here is the passenger ships. Now there is a word called the jetty, there is a word called the breakwater, there is a word the basin. So likewise we are going to look at different words. So simply this is the layout of a simple layout of any port or harbor. Now what is the difference between the port and harbor? So we are trying to compare the harbor and port. Basically a harbor is a very large the area in water. So the port may be part of it, or a port may be combination of one or two harbors. So a harbor cannot be located inside a port, whereas a port is located inside a harbor. So we can say the port is the part of your harbor. A harbor is usually natural structure, whereas the ports are mainly artificially created. Why it is called as artificially created? Because we want to provide different facilities. So in that case, we need to construct some structures. So therefore, it is called as the, just like to loading and unloading. So that activity will go on in the ports. So this is the part, port is the part of the harbor itself. A harbor may not provide as many facilities as port. So we are also going to look at in different slides what the very specific functions of the ports. The ports are commercial entities and have many facilities like the warehouses to store cargo and well built transportation system. What is the warehouse? Where is house these? It's just like a permanent godown. The purpose of harbor is to provide the shelter from weather conditions. So basically any harbor main purpose is to provide the shelter from the weather conditions, let it be very the wind, very high winds, in order to avoid any kind of the accidents. The harbor can also be helpful for the halting. and the purpose of port is just to load and unload the cargo. So in very short, we can see here all ports are harbors, whereas as all harbors are not ports. So not necessary, you must have so far understood that the ports are actually the commercial entities where the all the activities will go on, but harbors may not be for the activity purpose. So what is the meaning of this statement? So you can see here in this diagram, this is a picture. So this is the simple and natural port. So basically, harbor is a space or area in water where it gives the protection from the winds. And where's the port? You can see here, port is the structure or the part of your harbor which is used for the different activities. So therefore it is constructed for the, you can see here, artificially constructed. Okay. Types of the harbors. So types of harbors, basically they are based on, first one is the safety required. So if I say there are different the types of this, natural, semi-natural and artificial. So this is called a semi-natural. Mostly we have used words semi-artificial, but here the word is a semi-natural. Then second one is based on the location. I have not written due to the short of the space, but we are going to see different types of the harbors based on location. Third one is the usage. So in usage, you can see there are the four types. One is the commercial, then fishery harbor, military and marine harbor. So the name itself indicates its utility. Based on safety required, the very first is the natural harbor. So you can see the Mumbai harbor and Kandla port, you can say harbor or port, you can say anything alternatively, because these are the synonymous words. These are the examples in our country. Kandla is the port which is situated in Gujarat. So what is the natural harbor? A harbor is an area, to define just once again, of water that is protected from the wind and the waves. Harbor is sheltered body of water where ships boats can be docked. Okay, so that what is the dock, that we are also going to see, harbors and docks. What is the name of one of the mode of the transportation or content of this here the model. So the dock we are going to see later on. So natural harbors that form naturally, very first thing. How we can say naturally? So by the species which is protected by the mountains, bays and islands. So you can see in this diagram, most of the sites they are naturally protected. So you can see most of the portion here itself, the portion here of water is very calm as compared to the portion somewhere here. So from all the sides, this is the protection. So this is naturally available. One more that you can see here also, this is one of the same thing. So the, if you see diagrammatically how it can be shown here, so this is the shore and this is the wind from the, from this is the mountains from here or from here. So very much the protected area are like this. So the natural harbor, where the natural harbors are available, the development will be very fast in terms of the population. The geographical features which are nearby to that are very much rapid. So therefore you must have noticed that wherever there are the natural harbors, they are very fastly growing cities and become metropolitan cities. Based on safety required, that again we are going to see semi-natural harbor. The Visakhapatnam is the port in Andhra Pradesh which is coming under the semi-natural harbor. What is happening in the semi-natural harbor? This portion is naturally available, but you can see the, if you want to restrict the area from the wind and the waves, we need to provide the hindrance by constructing this, we call it the breakwater. So the wherever the wind which is coming from this has the getting the less area to enter into that. So this is the example. You can see this this picture. So this portion which you can see here, which is the natural available, but this portion was very much large. That opening we have to restrict this. By restricting, we can say allowing only this much passage to enter, to allow the ships enter into the harbors or in this space where this portion will be very much calm, and this will be only possible by constructing this portion and this portion artificially. So what we can say in this semi-natural harbor, it requires more protection against the wind and waves, and at the entrance man-made constructions they are required. So these are the man-made constructions you can see here. Then third one is the artificial harbor. Artificial harbor where no scope for the natural protection is available. So Chennai is the developed artificial harbor. So all the constructions will be man-made and does not contain any natural protection. So most of the times the man-made protections which are in the forms of the breakwater, sea walls, the jetties. So this is the, you can see the breakwater. So breakwater, the more is the length of this breakwater, you can say that the more it will give the protection against the winds and the waves. One of the example of this is the artificially constructed reclamation. You can see here in this the harbor which is constructed in Dubai. So where the breakwaters are structures, most of the times you can say there are different breakwaters from here to here all around, and in between here the localities they are developed here. Now based on location, second classification we are going to look at. In this, based on location, first one is the sea harbor. So mostly the countries which are connected internationally, they are connected with the sea. So the harbor developed, we call it the sea harbor. So loading and unloading are done in large quantities at seaport, and different countries connected to this seaport. This is very very short information in which is that this is sufficient for describing this. Then second is the river harbor. So mostly we have the impression in our mind that the harbor should always possess natural feature as a seawater. It is not so. River could also be providing the harbor also. So these harbors are constructed in river and finally they are connected to the sea. So this harbor enable the navigation. So basically the purpose of this river harbor is to provide the navigation inside the country from the non-coastal areas. So where the coastal area, where the sea is available, we call it the coastal area, and where there rivers are there, we call it the non-coastal area. The third one is the canal harbor. The canal harbor, which cannot be seen in our country, but in foreign countries you can see here. So on both the sides, banks of this canal, there are the civilization that took place. So these harbors are very similar to river harbors, and the canal is connected to sea, and then this canal will join to the major river, and that river again is connected to the sea. Now based on usage, we are going to third type classification based on usage. In this we will see very first is the commercial harbor. So these harbors are where loading and unloading of cargo can be done. Mostly they are for the trading purpose. These harbors require large area for speed up of the different operations, and busiest than any other the harbor. Some harbors are limited to loading and unloading. So that means only the single commodity like coal, crude oil, these are the only single commodity that or large ships they will carry. Some quick repair work can also be done in this case of the commercial harbor. So this commercial harbor is also used for the very quick repair work. Then second, fishery harbor. So therefore, where the fishing can be done in this harbor are specially meant to cargoes carrying the seafood or aquatic animals. They are always open to fishing ships for loading and unloading. Along with this, preserving seafood, for the preserving of seafood, sufficient space should be provided near this. Then third one is the sorry fourth one military harbor. This is the military harbor. So the Mumbai and Cochin, these are the two different the ports where these military harbors, we can see mostly these are the for naval bases. And during no work or repair works, where the warships, they are no more in operation, you can see these are for the halting purpose, or we can say for they are rested. No private ship can enter without the permissions. They are very restricted harbors. Some large naval vessels, so you can see vessels is a, you can say any ship starting from very small boat to very large ship. So as it says the naval vessel, it definitely it will be very large ship and which will carry the aircrafts. So this therefore the for the some large naval vessels carry aircraft, also therefore large space is required for in this harbor. So therefore when these large vessels are required, so therefore this harbor should also have large. Then one more, the marina harbor. The marina harbors are small harbors where the moorings are provided. What is the moorings? Moorings is nothing but just like an anchoring of the boats for the yachts and small ships. They are not suitable for large cargoes, and the boats, ship repair work, fueling can be done in this harbor. So you can see this is very much a well developed the marina harbor. Now you can see along our coastal region what are the different seaports or sea harbors. So you can see there is the Kandla in Mumbai, which is called as a Nhava Sheva, you can JNPT, Mormugao, Mangalore, Kochi. So they are the different along with this from starting from the west to the east side. This is a general layout of the once again of any harbor. Now we are going to look at what are the different features of your harbor. Very first is your entrance of the channel, entrance channels where actually the ships or any vessels they will enter into the harbor. Then berthing and turning basin, the breakwater, the pier and pier head that we are also going to see, quays and wharves. These are very different the names. Perhaps you may require some more times to understand and to remember these words. Jetties and piers, the docks, the slipways, and the last one the miscellaneous. Now you can see here, as we were talking about what is the breakwater, so you can see here is the breakwater. This is again the pictorial view of this. So this is the breakwater. This breakwater is required to reduce the currents which are coming from the winds and the waves. Then you can see this is the entrance actually which is coming to the harbor. Then there is the jetty. Just to show here, we are going to see all these words in details. Small boat harbor, this is the small boat harbor, you can see here the anchorage area, turning basin, four different port facilities here. Now very first the entrance channels. So as its name indicates, you can see the entrance channel is like this somewhere here. So this is the path, this is the path in water area through which ship can enter the harbor safely. Now you must have seen that how much it wide and what should be, how much should be wide and how much is the, how much should be the depth of water, that will depend upon the importance of the that harbor. So data involves some calculation part. some relationships that we did not go in detail. Now, when sea around the harbor require separate approach for the larger ship visiting the harbor. So you can say this is they call it the entrance as well as the approach channel. You can also call it as an approach channel also. So at entrance channel, demarcated and dredged for required depth. What is the dredge mean? We some need to excavate at this approach channel, and this approach channel how much it should be wide will be decided how much deep you want. So very large vessel if it is expected to enter into inside the harbor, so the when water carrying some silt and the silt get deposited, and if a ship is very large, so the frequent removal of the siltage is required. So that removal is called as a dredging. Then after that, width depends on the density of traffic and number of these tenders. So as I was telling you, how much it should be wide, so depending upon the what is the density of the traffic and number of the entrances. So these are the general guidelines of this. For the small harbor, it should be about 100 meters wide. If it is medium harbor, it is about 100 to 160 meters, and if it is large, then the range between 160 to 260 meters. Yeah, here. So how it is made? This is some whether it is constructed, the basins which are constructed at an angle, perpendicular or parallel, depending on we call it the different terms. So therefore, the pier here is which is at an angle to the shore. It is a platform at which the berthing of ships is possible on both sides. So in some of the platforms where the berthing or the parking of the ship, that will only be possible only one side. How that we are also going to see. So it may be a solid the pier or it can be open pier. So if it is a solid, it may be consist of the concrete or rubber masonry, and if it is open pier, it could be of a timber. So you can see this one is the solid pier, and this one is called the timber pier. The pier head. What is the pier head? The pier head are nothing but it's a solid platform at which the berthing of ship is possible. This need to be changed. So you can see the pier head is nothing but every just like a lighthouse, you can show here, and this one is the breakwater. At the end of breakwater, you can provide a lighthouse, the indication to the ships or vessel that you have to enter or you have come close to the approach. In the second diagram, you can see also same thing. Here is your pier head. So it doesn't mean that it is provided on a pier. So don't make a confusion. Pier head is the head or a small just like a lighthouse which is provided at the end of breakwater. Okay, but not the pier. Yeah, somewhere it is shown like this. The structure provided at the tip of breakwater, and it serves the purpose of entrance mark such as lighthouse. Now here valves and quays. Valves. What is the valves? The platforms or the loading places come close enough to the shore. So you can say these are the platforms, and the ships, they are coming very close to this so that loading or unloading can be done with berthing facilities to one side. Now what it denotes, any structure of timber, masonry or cement or any other material built along with sufficient depth of water to accommodate vessels. Okay, so you can see here one more diagram. So there are some different these small ships, they are aligned, and loading and unloading can be done with the instrument which is provided here on the wharf. Quays are the wharf itself which are constructed parallel to the shore, or breakwater, they are called as a quays. So you can see here there is a very large area which is constructed along the shore. So they are serving the same purpose as the valves. Here also on this side or in this side or at the end of this. So this is possible. So it is used mostly for handling inflammable materials like coal, petrol, diesel, kerosene. So when it is expected that these the ships which are carrying this inflammable material, they should be far away from the seashore. Then when it's consisting of the solid structure, so it can be used for the dragging in approach channel and used more prevention for silting in approach channel. So when you want to say avoid any dislogging of the ships, so here you can provide these are the projection of the piles, and this is the water level, and above this water it will go up. So this is the kind of the construction which is provided. The docks. Docks are enclosed areas for berthing the ships. So this is also berthing the ships. That means this is a parking of the ships itself, but the purpose is here different, to keep them afloat at a uniform level to facilitate loading and unloading cargo. Why is this so? So you might ask that if the ships are floating on water, so why you want to provide a uniform level? So there are unexpected low tides and high tides. So there are some ships which are rested for a more number of the days. In that case, the level water level may goes fluctuating. So in that case, if the ships are loaded or unloaded, in that case we want to maintain the water level uniform. So how it can be done? By providing is just like a chamber. You can see here one chamber, okay, and here the water level inside is maintained constant by closing the gate here. So the regulating gate, you can maintain the water level. As ship requires number of days for discharging a cargo, during which the ships need uniform level, as I was telling you initially. These are also known as the harbor docks. Only docks or harbor docks. The docks are classified as wet dock and the dry dock. So wet docks, they are usually called as the harbor docks. So docks require for berthing of ships or vessels to facilitate loading and unloading of the passenger and cargo, and the dry dock, they are used for the repair of the ships. So you must have understood what is the difference between the wet docks, where you want to say the only loading and unloading should be done, we go for the wet docks, and only for the repairing of the ships we go into the dry dock. Further, dry docks can be classified into five types: the gravity docks, or simply called as the dry dock, floating dry dock, marine dry dock, ship lift, and slipways. Now here you can say the gravity or dry dock. Mostly this is mostly asked in the question university paper also. So what are the different components of this? Is this, so you can see, one is the side walls, then semicircular end wall, and the floor. So you can see here, this is a chamber which is provided here, and when the ship enters into this in the dry, no water here all around this. So this is only in standing condition. There are one more dock, is the dry dock. They are also classified into five categories. This is the second type of the among the five, floating dry dock. Dry dock, so you can see, provide the arrangement is the just like floating. This is a slipway. Slipway, simply that the slip into the water. So you can see one more layout of this. This is one of the proposed master plan of one of the dock harbor. So you can see there is a, what you can see here, the pier head, there is the breakwater. So you can see there are different the quays we are provided, berthing purpose. Some are maybe perpendicular to the seashore, some may be parallel to the seashore. This is the parallel, so you can see like the arrangement will be there. This is the jetty. This is the ship which is used either different purpose, you can say fueling or loading and unloading. This is a few the last one, the planning construction for harbor. So very first, if you want to go for construction of any harbor, so very first we go for the topographic survey, which will include the soil investigation and the we should see the what are the different strata below the earth. So we can say in the form of geological data. Then we go for the hydrographic survey, where we want to know what is the depth of water, whether it how much or how different sizes of the vessels they are need to be accommodated. So we go for the depth of water we want to know, and this can be carried out with two techniques. One is the sounding pole and the sounding cable. In hydrographic surveying last year you must have studied this. And one is the echo. So this echo sounder is the electronic instrument, and this sounding pole and sounding cable, these are the actually the units to be required to insert into the water, or the devices which is to be inserted into the water. Then what is the availability of material and the land, then accessibility and traffic potential, how much the number of the different vessels they need to be allowed to accommodate. Then seismic data, in which zone seismic zone it this will come. Meteorological data, so just like what is the intensity of wind, that we want to know. Meteorological data, oceanographic, the wave currents we want to know to understand how much intensity it will be coming. And last one, go for the model testing. So this is the top view of Mumbai port. If you want to learn more, so you can click on this the YouTube channel. Thank you very much.